Hey, I have an idea. What do you say we finish Popful meal? Dun dun dun. Of course, I'm not going to finish it today, although I should, considering how long I've been putting this off. I'm sorry. I don't know what else to say. I have no excuse for how long it's taking me to finish this. This area is a pain in the ass, but I shouldn't, you know, I need to just power through it. It's what I have to do. I will be saving frequently from here, from this point on. Just in case, just to be on the safe side. So yeah, I won't finish Popful Mail today, but I will be very close by the end of this video. So close, I can taste it. Don't taste your video games. It's not healthy. This is the Maniac Mazes. These snails, you can stun lock them if you hit them with just the right timing. Otherwise, they go back into their shells, and you just have to jump to get them to open up again. Alright. The maze part hasn't started yet. It's pretty straightforward for the next couple rooms. And then the monster holding zone is where things really start to go batshit insane. Maximum protective gear. Well, I don't have the maximum protective gear yet, but I will soon, because as you can see, I have 37,000 gold, which should be enough to buy all the best equipment for everyone in the game. And I also have 14 of these amulets. Might be a little bit overkill. I probably won't need that many, but just to be on the safe side. Amulets, of course, protect you from damage, but you can't hurt enemies while you have it equipped, so they're pretty useless against the boss. But there are a few sections coming up where it'll be tremendously useful to have those. Again, 14, probably not necessary, but I like to be prepared, and then I have 10 apples and 5 bananas as well. So yeah, let's do this thing. No, not yet. Take one more room until the real maze starts. And I have notes typed up, that's how big of a nerd I am. I have a freaking text document open telling me exactly the way I have to go through here. Let me go ahead and bring that up. Okay. Need to go through this door, then kill the snail, this metallic robot snail thing. Why is it here? What purpose does it serve? I don't know. Through the door here, then go down these steps and enter the first door. Alright, I am on the right track. And I need to keep going this way. And there is a banana down here, which I will happily obtain. Okay. Up here. Alright. Switch to good old golf for this section. And there's an apple up here, I think. I believe it's an apple. Yes. And I'll go ahead and keep Gaul out because he'll be useful up here. There's a jumping section where he will be most helpful. Okay. Alright. Need to go this way. So, how have you guys been? I have been doing pretty well, despite my recent absence from the internet and the Let's Play community and the streaming community in general. Let's see. Alright. There's some kind of item up here. The Borderlands 2 stream has been fun. I haven't done that either lately. It's just, you know, there's so many things that I want to do and so little time for any of it. It sucks. Working 40 hours a week. Okay. I think I need to... Oh, wait. No. I need to do something over here first. Well, I don't need to do this, but, it's another item down here. Just another banana. So, yeah, I will be finishing up Popful Mail shortly. Well, hopefully shortly. Relatively shortly. And then I will be moving on to Dungeon Hack, which is the next donation LP. Okay. Okay, yeah, this is right. Then I jump off over here, but I have to hold left. There we go. Alright, we are about to fight a boss. Let's save this puppy. I don't know who will be the best choice for this boss. Really, I'm just going to have to kind of brute force my way through this one. This is not an easy boss. Well, the second half of the boss is pretty easy. But the first half, the Clobbster. I think I predicted it would be a big, weird lobster thing. And my prediction turned out to be accurate. Okay. Oh, God. And I immediately get hit. Alright, in this form, he basically has two attacks. He has these bubbles that you can pop by attacking them. And he has this wave attack that you have to jump over. And I am already deeply boned. Okay, let's see if I can salvage this. Oh, God. Yeah, Gaul is useful for this fight because you can jump over those waves a lot more easily. And I'm out of fuel, so I will have to retreat momentarily. Man, I'm already way, way down in health. Oh, God. Help if you face the right way, Gaw. Oh, shit. Okay. Well, it's not that bad. I can still pull this out. So yeah, in the time I haven't been LPing, I have been working on a game. I downloaded the free version of Game Maker just because I had an idea and I thought it would be fun to mess around with that. And it's coming out pretty well so far. It's not in any kind of completed state, but the core mechanics are pretty much there. And yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. If anyone wants to help me playtest, let me know and I will send you the experimental build that I'm working on. Just a dumb shoot 'em up kind of thing with a twist. And I've had a lot of fun making it. I mean, it takes a lot of time. That's the only downside. But of course, anyone who's ever tried to make a game would already know that. Probably spent about 10 to 15 hours working on it for a game that takes like 15 minutes to beat or so. But, I mean, it's a lot of fun just figuring out the program, figuring out how to make things work. I look forward to finishing it and hopefully working on other games in the future. I also have sort of a text adventure thing that I've sort of been working on and off. That's not even close to being in a state where I can show that off yet, but yeah, that's sort of what I've been doing lately. That and reading a lot. I have been playing some games. The PC version of Spelunky came out, and that's a blast. Make sure you check that out, especially if you never played the Xbox 360 version. And if you're on the fence about Spelunky, I would recommend downloading the free version, which is still available, and see you know, just see if it strikes your fancy. And if it does, PC version definitely worth buying. I think it's $15. And I played SteamWorld Dig on the 3DS. That is a hell of a game. Highly recommended for anyone with the 3DS. I thought I read something about that coming to other platforms, which I hope it does. It's a pretty great game. It took me about 6 to 7 hours to beat. The game's $9. Not the longest game in the world, but it's sort of a exploration Metroidvania kind of thing, where you're constantly digging down underneath this town and discovering new awesome power-ups along the way. Animal Crossing, I'm pretty much done with. It's the same thing that happened with Wild World. I sort of, after a point, it's just... Oh, that's one down, one to go. But after a point with Animal Crossing, you're just like, why am I still playing this? What do I have to gain by turning this game on again? And, it's just kind of... I mean, it's fun, it's still cute, it's still adorable. Occasionally I will turn it on and just go around and talk to all the townspeople. But that's pretty much it. All the actual gameplay, it's not something that really keeps me coming back. I got Shin Megami Tensei 4, and I'm stuck. I'm really bad at that game. Not sure if I'll be going back to that. I've enjoyed it up to a point, but it just gets very, just brutally difficult. And I could turn the difficulty down, but I don't want to, it would be a blow to my gamer pride. Oh god. Oh Jesus. And I've also been playing Shadowrun Returns, which is excellent. I kickstarted that game, but am I going to be able... It's going to be hard for me to hit this guy. I kickstarted Shadowrun Returns, but I didn't start playing it until a few months. A few weeks. Oh god. After. And it's great. Very old school RPG. Just the kind of thing I enjoy. I think it's $20 on Steam. Oh, I don't like being on the side of the boss. Let me switch back to Gaw. And... Actually, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to use an amulet to get back on the good side of this guy. That's what I bought him for. But yeah, that's pretty much what I've been playing. And of course, I should have been playing this, but... you just kind of have to be in the right mood to do something like this. Oh my god. Oh god. I really don't... How many elixirs do I have? 3? That should be enough. Fuck it. I really don't want to have to start this boss fight over again. Ugh. God, why can't I just hit that guy? Okay, I need to be ready to equip an amulet. And I need to go about this more slowly and methodically. Oh god. The good thing is when your amulet runs out, it automatically switches to another one. So no need to worry about getting hit in the meantime. Come on, you bastard. Stop running away, I say as I run away. It would help if I was doing more than 3 points of damage per hit, of course. Wait, okay, I got it. Oh, there you go. Oh, thank god. Destroyed the Clobbster. Got the Dragonstone, whatever that does. I do not remember. what that item is for. Oh man, anything over here? No. Okay. I really hate using that elixir, but I don't want to do that. Again, 3 should be enough to see me through the end of the game. Hopefully. So this has been Let's Play Popful Mail. Sorry for the delay. We're pretty close. I expect probably maybe 3 or 4 videos at the most until the end of the game. I don't know how long that'll be in real time. Hopefully not as long as it has been. God, I wish I didn't lose that elixir. Oh well. Deep breath, Duke. It's going to be okay. It's just a video game. Alright, till next time, I'm Duke of the Bump. Bye.